What up, gang? So you guys have been killing it with the support. I hit 30k subs in like 2 months, which is absolutely ridiculous. It's beyond any expectations I had. I just wanted to say thank you for that. And today we're gonna do a little Q&A type of shit. I asked you guys to ask me some questions on my Instagram. Gonna answer a few of those today and hopefully allow you guys to get to know me a little better. Where are you from? I get this one a lot. Cause you talk funny, this and that. I was born in Zimbabwe. I lived there till I was about 18 months. Moved to South Africa, lived there most of my life, did 3 years in Dubai, back to South Africa, and then moved to the US when I was 15, so all around the world kind of shit. Biggest culture shock moving to the US. So there were two for me. The first day I pulled up to school, and the kid next to me decided to talk back to the teacher. I couldn't fucking believe it. You will get clipped up so quick in South Africa for doing that. You will be detention, your parents getting called, you'll be fucked. I couldn't believe it, and the teacher just sat there and took it. I thought, wow, this is something new. And then the next thing was the kush. I couldn't believe that people were just smoking kush left and right. They were dispensaries. I thought, you know, it's legal now in South Africa, but at the time it was fucking heinous, absolutely heinous. And the last thing, now that I think about it, when I first pull up to the grocery store and I saw they had fucking mini frozen tacos and burritos and they just had frozen everything. That was fucking absurd to me, you know. Now it's a part of everyday life, so crazy how things work out. Asshole tits kind of guy. I like a big bum. I'm gonna be honest, I do like a big bum, so I'm gonna go with ass. Do you have a job other than social media? I do crypto. I'm going to the moon, baby. Diamond hands all day. But yeah, like I said, we're going to the moon. I have a Discord, Heinous Pumps. It's been heinously pumping today. We hit 20,000 members. I think we're already up to 23,000. But yeah, you know, 23,000 members deep. We're making bread. You know, the reason I really love it is everyone in there has the same like mind, same kind of thinking. They're all there to better themselves. A lot of them came from my fitness TikTok. So it's, you know, guys that are looking to get healthy, live the healthier lifestyle. But at the same time, they want to up their bags, want to up their sack, which, you know, makes perfect sense. So there's that. You ever put a broad on the spit? What do you want me to say to that? How do you want me to answer that? Have I ever put a broad on the spit? If I had, do you think I'd say yes? There's no way I'm answering that question. Craziest Mexico story. Spoke about it in my first video. What happened was we were at the clubs and, you know, it's 18 and up there, so it's legal. But we were at the clubs just, you know, doing my thing, like in the fucking, it's like 3-4 in the morning, 2-3, somewhere around there, early hours of the morning. I am many shots of tequila deep, many. When there's those $1 bars, it's absolutely poisonous. It is fucking, and it's, that shit is not even real tequila. That shit, I don't even know what it's doing to my insides, but it's Cabo, it's spring break, you're not asking any questions. Was it spring break? I can't even remember, but it was in Cabo for sure. And it's early hours of the morning. I'm parking outside the club. I'm just bawling there. Yeah, I just start wandering off. I leave my friends and I walk down this back street. And a couple, you know, Cabo is pretty safe. The military and shit's on. You know, they got their fucking choppers there, their yappers, and they're always on there, on deck, making sure everyone's safe. But a couple streets back, there's no street lights, no one. It's all locals and it's dodgy. And I looked up, I was a couple streets back. I'd gone on a walk. And I ended up pulling up outside this hotel, motel thing. I'd never fucking seen it in my life. I'm just bawling outside there. These fools pull up on me, hitting me with the Ola Ola Amigo shit. And I'm like, oh, fuck. You know, I'm standing there, little fucking, what was that, chubby blonde fucking kid, just standing, little white kid, just standing in the streets of Mexico, confused. I hit the dash. You know, I hadn't discovered a calorie deficit at this time, so these fucks caught me up in absolutely no time. Put me in a fucking whip and start driving me around. I'm tweaking so hard. I'm so sauced and I'm just sitting in the back of a car with these fools spitting Spanish. And I'm like, oh, fuck me. We end up doing, you know, a couple little whips around in circles. I don't even know. They drive around with me. Next thing I know, we stop. I look out the fucking window of the whip and one of my homies is talking to one of their homies. They do a little negotiation swap. I get out of there. And, you know, let me out the whip. I get in a taxi with my homie and I've never been so pumped in my entire life. You know, I don't even really say anything because I'm kind of still in shock. Pull up back to the hotel and, you know, I say to him, bro, what the fuck happened? I'm like, bruv, how much you corker? What did they sting you? He's like, oh, I paid them 40 bucks. I'm like, 40 bucks for that shit? 40 fucking bucks. I was obviously though so sauced, I didn't have my wallet. I don't know what the fuck was going on. I'm just happy we made it out. And you know, glad I can tell the tale. I won't be doing that again. I did act in, I don't know about that one. Do I go to school? I don't go to school. You know, I dropped out of Arizona State about a month ago, just over a month, month and a half. And, you know, I've decided I want to do what I want to do. I don't agree with the schooling system at all. I think it's broken. I think something new needs to be put into place. But unfortunately, in today's world, I also do think that you need a degree to be successful. Or it's at least going to, I don't think, I take that back. You don't need a degree to be successful, but it's going to make it a lot fucking easier. It's going to open doors for you. So my advice is, if you don't have another plan, get that degree, have it as something to fall back on, chase your dreams, you know, at the same time. But if those don't work, you have that degree to fall back on. You know, I've decided that the position that I'm in, I think I'm good enough. You know, I've been doing well with crypto over the last couple of years, so that's just, that's my plan going forward. Take care like cash cow. Penthouse suite.